Greetings, fellow hominoids. Back in 1998, I was suffering from the effects of listening to the 888 converter before the ubiquitous word interface was coined, manufactured by the artist formerly known as Video Design. That black box of Doom's filter rang like a church bell. No matter what you recorded, acoustic guitar, vocals, drums, you got this trace of aww. So did that mean we had to retune all our guitars and even toms to the key of aww? In stepped the Apogee 88000 SE. SE stood for Special Edition, which sold for $6,000. That's almost 10K in today's money. I got all lathered up to audition this bad boy and realized, how do I turn the volume up and down to my monitors? So I called up Apogee and they told me to go to Guitar Center and purchase a little Mackie mixer. What? I just spent $6,000 to hear angels dancing on the head of a pin, and I'm supposed to take that and plummet down into the depths of Dante Alighieri's Inferno? Dangerous music to the rescue! You probably own an interface, and perhaps a pretty good one. You carefully considered the quality of the converters, how many inputs and outputs it had, and perhaps what plugins were included with it. But most people don't give the humble volume knob a second thought. Unfortunately, monitoring paths are not created anywhere near equally, and they happen to be the most critical part of your studio. Think about it. You can't mix what you can't hear. It's like trying to interpret a voice-to-text message from your grandmother, or finding your way on a map when the GPS is glitching and it's missing features like streets, rivers, railroad tracks, and your favorite dive bar. You're not stupid. You're not disoriented. You don't have all the information to succeed. From this moment forward, I absolve you of all of your previous sins because they were not your fault, my child.